Dr. Sri Ramalingam. I'm spine surgeon at Ortho One. I'm working in Ortho One for the past 5 years. I've done my fellowships in spine surgery with the National Board at New Delhi, and a few fellowships abroad with the British Spine Society, and now continuing here. Back pain is very common in our population. As you see, back pain doesn't happen in animals. It only happens in human beings. And the main reason being that we are basically quadrupeds, and now we have started in our bipedal postures. So when we start bipedal, automatically a spine which is supposed to be horizontal now becomes vertical. And with this vertical spine, we sit for a long time, like a sitting jobs, you lift weights. Whatever you do, always the stress on the spine is very high. And this is obviously going to cause back pain. And as you know, almost 95% of the population experiences back pain at some point of time in their life, which is significant enough to restrict their work. Most of the back pain patients do not need any special treatment itself. Most of them, like 80 to 90% of them, become all right just by taking rest. Rest of the patients, like 15 to 20% of them, will need some consultation with a doctor, and most of them will recover with physiotherapy, exercises and some painkillers. But there's a small subset of population who will need surgery. Now, who needs surgery is what is important. Now, the patient who has a back pain which is lasting for more than a month, not subsiding with medicines, back pain which is there at night, not allowing you to sleep properly, which disturbs your sleep, back pain which is associated with some weakness of the legs or weakness of the hands or fingers or numbness which is persisting, or a back pain in a patient who is already a known patient of some cancer or some serious illnesses which they are undergoing treatment and they have developed some associated back pain. These are serious conditions which we cannot ignore. These are the patients who will need specific treatments, may or may not be surgery. But otherwise, if you see, almost 95% of the population, back pain doesn't need surgery. It always becomes all right just with some physios, exercises and all. Now, we also should know how to prevent getting back pains. Now, the most important thing that will help us to prevent back pain is to keep ourselves fit. If your back muscles are fit enough, you don't get back pain often. So we always suggest you take up one of either of the four things: one, cycling; second one, walking or jogging; or swimming. So if you can take up any of these activities on a regular basis, do it at least 5 times in a week for at least 40 minutes in a day. Usually that helps you to prevent long-term back pains. Few tips more to prevent pain, or few ways of doing things properly, is like sit upright in a straight posture. If you are going to sit for a long time, make sure that you have a back support which is supporting your lumbar spine or the lower back in a very good way. If you are going to lift a heavy object, make sure that you bend your knees down, keep your back straight and then lift the object. And if you are traveling in a bike or car or whatever it is, make sure that you don't get into the gutter holes, or whenever you cross a hump, you take it slowly. So these are few things which you can do to prevent any injury to the spine. There is a common belief that back pain is very common with people who are obese or overweight, and especially in women. Now the thing is, it's a myth. You don't get back pain just because you are obese or overweight. If your muscles are strong enough, whatever be your weight, if you are proportionately strong enough, you don't get pain. So it is about how obese you are, what kind of obesity you got. If you got a pot belly, or if you have a protuberant abdomen, that puts a lot of strain in your back and that can cause back pain. So it's not that you are overweight, you have to get back pain. So if your weight is more also, it doesn't matter. If you are going to keep yourself proportionate, your body is proportionate, your back muscles are strong, you are fit enough, then you don't get pains. We get land into trouble which needs a spine surgery. The most common question that I get is spine surgery complicated? How good or bad is the success? Now, spine surgery is not complicated. Only thing is it needs definitely a more amount of accuracy, which needs special equipments and which needs a special setups. Provided you are getting it done in a proper setup, the success rate is extremely high. And maybe the failure rate or something or complications, you can compare it just to any other orthopedic surgery involving the limbs. It is not more than anything else. This is now made very clear with the international societies which do studies on spine surgery. They have clearly shown that the complications in spine surgery is not more than the complications of any other limb surgery or other surgeries. It's the same now that we have all these equipments, and complications can be easily avoided. And our motto itself is to do safe surgeries. So a safe spine surgery can help you regain your life back without much problems.